So we've seen how to read data from the database. We've seen how to send database commands like delete and insert to add and to remove stuff from the database. But it's probably just, I've been doing stuff a little bit sloppy, and I want to make sure we talk about some of the things that you have to worry about when you're taking data from users and using it inside your code. So if you recall, we talked about HTML injection, and the problem with HTML injection is if a user with ill intent, intentionally or even unintentionally, starts putting legitimate HTML into form tags, and you simply echo that without thinking, they can sort of take over your background document. And usually they're not just putting out the word die, die, die. They're putting something like JavaScript in. And so if you are putting raw user input out, the browser parses it differently. The browser doesn't realize that this bit came from the user, and it's a problem. And so this is a danger when you don't clean up your data. And of course, the solution to that is HTML entities, which then turns that into ampersand quote and all those other things, which you talked about before. There is a similar problem with SQL injection. It's the idea that the user can type something. And this turned out to be a giant problem in PHP because it was so convenient in PHP to do the wrong thing. And beginning developers, PHP is a favorite language of beginning developers, so it was easy to make a mistake, okay? And so PHP got a really bad reputation of highly insecure. It wasn't PHP's fault. PHP just made it really easy to be insecure. And as we talked about before, PHP is a language that expects that you're a responsible programmer. And actually, they did some silly things in PHP 4 to try to solve this problem, and it was really bad, and they've undone that. But PDO, which I'm going to show you, there's a happy ending. They finally figured this out in like PHP 5, but they tried to fix it in PHP 4 and did a bad job of it. If you see things like strip slashes in existing code, then you're like, oh, that's from the dark times of HTML injection. But SQL injection is users who are trying to take form fields and do bad things to your database. So let's just say that you didn't want to do that two-step process where I did the prepare and the execute is two steps. That's good practice. But you say, oh, wow, PHP has this wonderful ability to use these dollar signs inside of a double quotes. Wouldn't it be great and simple if I just did this? I just did a select statement with double quotes, and then I grabbed the email into this variable $E and the password in that, and I just put in a single quote inside here. Away we go, and so that'll just put the stuff right from the form fields right into this SQL, and then we're just going to run the SQL. This is bad. Bad, bad, bad. Really evil. Okay, so let's show you what happens. Okay, the problem is we are taking end-user entered stuff, and then they can do things like they can take over our SQL. And it's even worse to take over our SQL because then they can break into our whole database. If they break into our HTML, they kind of can steal cookies and stuff of one or a few users that get caught by it. But in the database, they're in. They've got all your stuff. If they can get a hold of your database password and they're in and run generic commands on your database, you are in deep, deep trouble. So SQL injection is worse in a way. Not that either one is good, but it's even worse than HTML injection. So let's see what happens here. So let's say we've got our little user table here, right? And so we've got user ID, we've got the password, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And so we type in a person's email and we type the wrong password and we submit the login. And it basically says, using that code I just showed you, it says select name from users where email equals csev@umich.edu and password equals wrong. It simply take these two values and stuck them into that string, right? And then it does a select from that, and if it didn't get a record, then it says you didn't log in, right? Because it's matching both the email and the password. So that's pretty good, right? Worked just fine. That's a quick way to log people in. You do a query and then see if you got a row. And if you didn't get a row, you don't log them in. If you did get a row, you do log them in. That's kind of how login works. Okay, so what could possibly go wrong? So this, I haven't done anything evil. The whole idea of these injection attacks is that you're going to do something evil in these forms that you can sneak into the SQL and do a bad thing. Okay, so Here is an XKCD cartoon. That's a very important cartoon. It is the canonical cartoon about SQL injection. I'll read it to you. So there is a mom, and she is making a call to the school, and she says, hi, or the school calls, says to the mom, hi, this is your son's school. We're having some computer trouble. And mom says, oh dear, did he break something? And they said, the school says, in a way. And the school says, did you really name your son Robert single quote parenthesis semicolon drop table student semicolon dash dash question mark? That's the school. And mom says, of course, we named him little Bobby Tables. And then the school says, well, we've lost this year's student records. I hope you're happy. And mom says, the very technically astute mom says, I hope you've learned to sanitize your database inputs. Or I would say, I hope you've learned an SQL injection lesson about how to do SQL injection and avoid it. Another way to say is, I hope you've learned to use PDO rather than doing string substitution to do your queries, okay? Or prepared statements rather than string substitution. Now, this is funny, and everyone loves this. I once met a student who changed their login name to null. So another fun thing to put into fields is null, because null is a keyword. And so if your name is N-U-L-L, but they use it wrong on the in the wrong place, then some things will behave differently for null. So I've met people who have actually tried to do this. There's things on the internet where people like create a license plate that's like semicolon drop table traffic or something, so that a computer will read this thing, do image processing on the text, and then hopefully they'll format the database of the whatever. But you get the idea. So, okay, that's a joke. I probably ruined it for you because I just am not a good joke teller. But the key thing is to put this single quote in, because the single quote is an active character, and they're expecting that this will be in some SQL, and then this will be the end of that, and then they're going to run a second SQL command. Semicolon, as we saw in SQL, allows you to run more than one command on the same line. Now, it turns out that they've taken this particular thing, meaning that PDO doesn't, unless you ask it to, respect semicolons in a single query. So they've kind of fixed this. You can't quite do this one. It'd be so fun if you could. But the modern PDOs and the modern databases, they don't let this one happen because it's just too bad. But we can still do bad things. And there are ways that they figure this thing out, right? And so remember here how we have this. We're going to make this select statement, and then we are going to whatever the user types we're going to put in right there. And what if I put in, P quote or 1 equals 1 quote. So I now, with no modification, have put in this bit right here. Okay? And not that single quote, not that close quote. Sorry, let me start that over again. Let me get this right. From the P to the one, but with neither quote. So the two quotes are part of the original SQL. And just like an HTML injection, that's not how SQL looks at it. It says the password, it's where the email is csv@umich.edu and the password is p or 1 equals 1. Well, 1 equals 1 is always going to be true, so this is always going to be true. So even though I don't know the password, I'm logged in. And so even though I can't use the semicolon trick to do really bad things, right? That'd be more fun. It'd be fun to say drop tables right here, but you can't because it doesn't look in this string. Semicolons are not respected in that string, even though they are respected when you're doing PHP MyAdmin. When you're doing a PDO query here, it says, I think we're not going to do semicolons because it's so dangerous. And so you can tell it to do semicolons, but you can't. But by default, it doesn't do semicolons. But it doesn't mean that this is without database, without HTML, the SQL sanitization or doing this properly. What they want to do is they want to break in and figure out and log into your administrator account and then start doing all kinds of stuff with your administrator account, or figure out what your password is, or figure out what your admin password is, or figure out what your database password is by surreptitiously logging in. And so even though you can't quite drop the tables the way XKCD wants us to drop tables, now, that's the bad news. And prior to PHP 5, there was a long description about how to do this. But with PHP 5 and PDO, and this is one of the reasons that I'm like, don't use anything but PDO, This prepare statement that I've already showed you the pattern for does this perfectly. And so what happens here is we have this little place that's going to have the email and the password, but we have just these two little placeholders, right? We're not actually putting the text. And the prepare is reads through and finds these little placeholders, and then it puts in the user data. But in this act of executing, it is doing stuff to this to properly escape it, kind of like what HTML entities did for HTML, except we don't even do it. We just know that this works, meaning that this cannot suffer. If you're doing this, email and password cannot be used to do SQL injection because the prepared statement escapes the data properly automatically, and you don't even have to escape the data. In the early days in MySQL underscore routines prior to PHP 5, prior to PDO, we had all these escaping routines that are kind of like HTML entities, but they were kind of ugly. You just use prepared statements and a story. You don't have SQL injection. If you start concatenating stuff together, including end user data, then you're in trouble, right? Don't concatenate things together that came from the end user. Just use prepared statements. They're just another extra line. It's elegant. It's simple. It makes your SQL look pretty. You're not doing ugly concatenations. And so away it goes. Okay? So just use PDO. Use prepared statements when you ever use it. So insert, delete, etc. Anything that you're putting user data in, you got to use these little placeholders, including selects. You might have a where clause in a select, where name equal or email equals EM. Well, this is a select, right? This one right here is a select. Even though this is a select, it's okay. We can get ourselves in trouble if we don't properly escape user input, even on a select statement. So up next, we're going to talk a little bit about more what'll go wrong. This is less about the SQL injection that we just got done talking about, and more about when you have syntax errors in your SQL. So like if you can't type select correctly, or you use a field that doesn't exist. And so it's a little bit tricky, and there's a lot of flexibility in how PDO errors are handled. I talked about this at the beginning of the previous thing when we set up PDO.php, but now we're going to look at it in some greater detail.